sculpting my life in a sculpture, and I ain't about to start now.
Well, I'd like to see you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Why? What has Dorothy done?
Oh, what's she done? I'm all but laying from the bite of my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
Oh, she bit her dog, eh?
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken from the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
You don't need to waste away, and I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here a minute? I'm sure if she's done anything to upset you, she'd be more than glad to apologize as best she can. Dorothy? Dorothy, Miss Gulcher seems very upset. That dog is a menace to the community.
That's not true.
Well, as an act of public service, young woman, I'm taking that dog to the sheriff and make sure he's destroyed.
Destroyed? Toto? Oh, you can't. You mustn't. Uncle Henry, Auntie Anne, you won't let him, will you?
Of course we won't. Will we?
Oh, Auntie Anne, please. Toto didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one who ought to be punished. You can send me to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is? Surely if you promise.
I'm afraid it's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I've already laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
How would it be if we kept him tied up? He's very gentle. With gentle folk, that is.
Well, that's for the sheriff to decide. Here's an order allowing me to take him, unless you'd like to get ill against the law.
Yes.
What's it say, then?
Just what she says. You gotta hand him over, Dorothy.
No!
I can't go against the law, Dorothy. I'm afraid poor Toto will have to go.
No! I won't let you, or I'll bite you myself!
Dorothy!
You go away, you wicked old witch! Uncle Henry! Auntie Anne, don't let her take him! Please don't let her take him!
I'll stop her!
It's no use running, Dorothy.
Hickory, I thought you were my friend.
He is your friend. We all are.
You can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
We haven't, Dorothy.
Uncle Henry, don't.
Now you're seeing reason.
Give him to her, Henry.
Oh, Toto!
That's more like it.
Elmira Gulch, just because he's on half the county does not mean you have the power to ruin the rest of us. For 23 years, I have been dying to tell you what I think of you. And now, well, being a Christian woman, I can't say it.
Well, I can, so if you don't want to hear it, you'd better peddle your carcass off of my land, Miss Gulch.
Oh, I don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Now, just remember, I have friends in high places.
Then why don't you call him on your broomstick and go visit him? You got the horse hitched to that wagon yet?
Nearly done, Mr. Gale.
Nearly ain't good enough. You get it done right now. It's getting darker every minute, goddammit.
No, I'm not going anywhere with you. If you really loved me, you wouldn't have let her take Toto.
Still could have tried at least.
Oh. You stood there like you were stuffed or something.
I just couldn't think of anything. I'm sorry.
One mean old woman and you were afraid.
It weren't my place to interfere.
And you're worst of all. You stopped Toto from getting away.
sculpt in my life, Miss Gulch, and I ain't about to start now.
Well, I'd like to see you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Why? What has Dorothy done?
Oh, what she done? I'm all but laying from the bite of my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
Oh, she bit her dog, eh?
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken from the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
You don't need to waste away, and I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here a minute? I'm sure if she'd done anything to upset you, she'd be more than glad to apologize as best she can. Dorothy, Miss Gulcher seems very upset. That dog is a menace to the community.
That's not true.
Well, as an act of public service, young woman, I'm taking that dog to the sheriff and make sure he's destroyed.
Destroyed? Toto? Oh, you can't. You mustn't. Uncle Henry, on TM, you won't let him, will you?
Of course we won't. William?
Oh, on TM, please. Toto didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one who ought to be punished. You can send me to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is? Surely if you promise
I'm afraid it's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I've already laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
How would it be if we kept him tied up? He is very gentle. With gentle folk, that is.
Well, that's for the sheriff to decide. Here's an order allowing me to take him, unless you'd like to get ill against the law.
Yes.
What's it say, then?
Just what she says. You gotta hand him over, Dorothy.
No!
I can't go against the law, Dorothy. I'm afraid poor Toto will have to go.
No! I won't let you go! I'll bite you myself,
Dorothy!
You go away, you wicked old witch! Uncle Henry! Auntie Anne, don't let her take him! Please don't let her take him!
I'll stop her!
It's no use running, Dorothy.
Hickory, I thought you were my friend.
He is your friend. We all are.
You can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
And you haven't, Dorothy.
Uncle Henry, don't.
Now you're seeing reason.
Give him to her, Henry.
Oh, Toto!
That's more like it. Elmira Gulch, just because you own half the county does not mean you have the power to ruin the rest of us.
For 23 years, I have been dying to tell you what I think of you. And now, well, being a Christian woman, I can't say it.
Well, I can, so if you don't want to hear it, you'd better peddle your carcass off of my land, Miss Gulch.
Oh, I don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Now, just remember, I have friends in high places.
Then why don't you climb on your broomstick and go visit them? You got the horse that's in that wagon yet?
Nearly done, Mr. Gale.
Nearly ain't good enough. You get it done right now. The sky's getting darker every minute, goddammit.
No, I'm not going anywhere with you. If you really loved me, you wouldn't have let her take Toto. There like you were stuffed or something. I just couldn't think of anything. I'm sorry. One mean old woman and you were afraid.
It weren't my place to interfere.
And you're worst of all. You stopped Toto from getting away. I just hate you.
Oh, don't say.
Thank you.
Skulk to my left, Miss Gulch, and I ain't about to start now.
Well, I'd like to see you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Why? What has Dorothy done?
Oh, what she done? I'm all but laying from the bite of my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
Oh, she bit her dog, eh?
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken from the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
You don't need to waste away, and I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here a minute? I'm sure if she'd done anything to upset you, she'd be more than glad to apologize as best she can. Dorothy? Dorothy, Miss Gulcher seems very upset. That dog is a menace to the community.
That's not true.
Well, as an act of public service, young woman, I'm taking that dog to the sheriff and make sure he's destroyed.
Destroyed? Toto? Oh, you can't. You mustn't. Uncle Henry, Aunt Tam, you won't let her, will you?
Of course we won't. Will we?
Oh, Aunt Tam, please. Toto didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one who ought to be punished. You can send me to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is? Surely if you promise
I'm afraid it's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I've already laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
How would it be if you kept him tied up? He is very gentle. With gentle folk, that is.
Well, that's for the sheriff to decide. Here's an order allowing me to take him, unless you'd like to get ill against the law.
Yes.
What's it say, then?
Just what she says. You gotta hand him over, Dorothy.
No!
I can't go against the law, Dorothy. I'm afraid poor Toto will have to go.
No! I won't let you all! I'll bite you myself, Dorothy!
You go!
To my left, Miss Gulch, and I ain't about to start now.
Well, I'd like to see you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Why? What has Dorothy done?
Oh, what she done? I'm all but laying from the bite of my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
Oh, she bit her dog, eh?
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken from the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
You don't need to waste away, and I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here a minute? I'm sure if she'd done anything to upset you, she'd be more than glad to apologize as best she can. Dorothy? Dorothy, Miss Gulcher seems very upset.
That dog is a menace to the community.
That's not true.
Well, as an act of public service, young woman, I'm taking that dog to the sheriff and make sure he's destroyed. Destroyed? Toto? Oh, you can't. You mustn't. Uncle Henry, Aunt Tam, you won't let her, will you?
Of course we won't. Will we?
Oh, Aunt Tam, please. Toto didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one who ought to be punished. You can send me to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is? Surely if you promise
I'm afraid it's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I've already laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
How would it be if you kept him tied up? He is very gentle. With gentle folk, that is.
Well, that's for the sheriff to decide. Here's an order allowing me to take him, Unless you'd like to get ill against the law.
Yes.
What's it say, then?
Just what she says. You gotta hand him over, Dorothy.
No! I can't go against the law, Dorothy. I'm afraid poor Toto will have to go.
No! I won't let you, or I'll bite you myself,
Dorothy!
You go away, you wicked old witch! Uncle Henry! Auntie Anne, don't let her take him! Please don't let her take him!
Oh, stop her!
It's no use running, Dorothy.
Hickory, I thought you were my friend.
He is your friend. We all are.
You can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
We haven't, Dorothy.
Uncle Henry, don't.
Now you're seeing reason.
Give him to her, Henry.
Oh, Toto!
That's more like it.
Elmira Gulch, just because you own half the county does not mean you have the power to ruin the rest of us. For 23 years, I've been dying to tell you what I think of you. And now, well, being a Christian woman, I can't say it.
Well, I can, so if you don't want to hear it, you better peddle your carcass off of my land, Miss Gulch.
Oh, I don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Now, just remember, I have friends in high places.
Then why don't you climb on your broomstick and go visit them? You got the horse that's not wagging yet?
Nearly done.
Nearly ain't good enough. You get it done right now. The sky's getting darker every minute, goddammit.
No. I'm not going anywhere with you. If you really loved me, you wouldn't have let her take Toto.
She had ordered from the sheriff, Dorothy. What did you expect me to do? Wave a wand and make it disappear?
You still could have tried at least.
Oh.
You stood there like you were stuffed or something. I just couldn't think of anything. I'm sorry.
One mean old woman and you were afraid.
It weren't my place to interfere.
And you. You're worst of all. You stopped Toto from getting away.
I just hate you!
Oh, don't say...
in my life, Miss Gulch, and I ain't about to start now.
Well, I'd like to see you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Why? What has Dorothy done?
Oh, what she done? I'm all but lame from the bite of my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
Oh, she bit her dog, eh?
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken from the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
You don't need to waste away, and I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here a minute? I'm sure if she'd done anything to upset you, she'd be more than glad to apologize as best she can. Dorothy? Dorothy, Miss Gulcher seems very upset.
That dog is a menace to the community.
That's not true.
Well, as an act of public service, young woman, I'm taking that dog to the sheriff and make sure he's destroyed.
Destroyed? Toto? Oh, you can't. You mustn't. Uncle Henry, Auntie Anne, you won't let her, will you?
Of course we won't. Will we,
sorry the child is. Surely if you promise.
I'm afraid it's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I've already laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
How would we if we kept him tied up? He's very gentle. With gentle folk, that is.
Well, that's for the sheriff to decide. Here's an order allowing me to take him, unless you'd like to get ill against the law.
Yes.
What's it say, then?
Just what she says. You gotta hand him over, Dorothy.
No! I can't go against the law, Dorothy. I'm afraid poor Toto will have to go.
No! I won't let you, or I'll bite you myself!
Dorothy!
You go away, you wicked old witch! Uncle Henry!
No use running, Dorothy.
Hickory, I thought you were my friend.
He is your friend. We all are.
You can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
You haven't, Dorothy.
Uncle Henry, don't.
Now you're seeing reason.
Give him to her, Henry.
Oh, Toto!
That's more like it.
Elmira Gulch, just because he's on half the county does not mean you have the power to ruin the rest of us. For 23 years, I've been dying to tell you what I think of you. And now, well, being a Christian woman, I can't say it.
Well, I can, so if you don't want to hear it, you'd better peddle your carcass off of my land, Miss Gulch.
Oh, I don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Now, just remember, I have friends in high places.
Then why don't you call him on your broomstick and go visit him? You got the horse into that wagon yet?
Nearly done, Mr. Gale.
Nearly ain't good enough. You get done right now. It's getting darker every minute, goddammit. In my life, Miss Gulch, and I ain't about to start now.
Well, I'd like to see you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Why? What has Dorothy done?
Oh, what she done? I'm all but laying from the bite on my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
Oh, she bit her dog, eh?
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I'm so shaken from the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
You don't need to waste away, and I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here a minute? I'm sure if she'd done anything to upset you, she'd be more than glad to apologize as best she can. Dorothy? Dorothy, Miss Gulch seems very upset.
That dog is a menace to the community.
true.
Well, as an act of public service, young woman, I'm taking that dog to the sheriff and make sure he's destroyed.
Destroyed? Toto? Well, you can't. You mustn't. Uncle Henry on TM, you won't let her, will you?
Of course we won't. William?
Oh, on TM, please. Toto didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one who ought to be punished. You can send me to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is? Surely if you promise...
I'm afraid it's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I've already laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
How would we if we kept him tied up? He is very gentle. With gentle...